I'm Lucine Sihelnik, founder of Gayatri Wellness. Today we're going to focus on a chair yoga routine. Yoga is for everyone, and sometimes it's just easier and more beneficial to do it in a seated position. So try to find a nice comfortable chair. Today I'm seated on a bench, which is really nice because it's sturdy and it doesn't have any sides. If you find that you have a chair, make sure that it is sturdy, it's not going to fold on you or tip from side to side, and that it doesn't have any arms, so that you can do this practice anytime, any day that you feel comfortable, so that you can do your yoga in the way that best suits you. So coming into a comfortable seated position, make sure your feet are flat. If you can reach the ground, press those feet into the ground. Sit up nice and tall, draw your navel to your spine, and bring your hands onto your lap, just so they're resting comfortably and gently. Now they can be palms down, palms up, whatever feels good for you. We're gonna come into our practice just like you would any other practice. So if you were seated on the floor or seated on a chair, really no difference, and that's the goal here, is to be able to show you a modified way to enhance your practice so you find the full benefit of yoga in your life. Let's close our eyes and try to relax the muscles behind the eyes, around the eyes, and all the muscles in the face. Try to relax the muscles through the forehead and the temples. Try to relax your jaw and make sure your teeth aren't clenched. And try to relax your throat. Take a deep, long breath in. And a deep, long breath out. Let's do that a few times. A nice, deep, long breath in. And a deep, long breath out. As you breathe in and out, try to fill the entire body with air. And when you exhale, try to release as much breath as possible. Let's do it one more time together. Deep breath in. And deep breath out. Keeping the eyes closed, take a deep breath in and just draw your chin towards your chest. Let your shoulders relax away from your ears, again, making sure that you're sitting up nice and tall and straight. Try not to lean into the back of the chair and lose this amazing posture that you're creating. With your chin towards your chest, start to feel the breath moving up and down the spine. If you want a deeper connection, you can imagine the breath coming through the earth, through the soles of your feet. As you inhale, imagine the breath traveling up through your legs and your spine to the top of your head and your crown. As you exhale, imagine that breath traveling back down. Visualization is a great tool to use if it's something that you like in your practice. If you find it distracting, just focus on your breath coming in and coming out. Allowing yourself to focus on the breath is a meditation and mindfulness within itself. Making sure that our breath is even, clear, and consistent. As we take a few more breaths, always remembering to let our movement and our postures sync with our breath. If we find that we're holding our breath in a posture, it's usually telling us that we need to hold back just a little bit more. Make the pauser a little bit more gentler for our body so that we can breathe deeply and fully. Let's take a deep breath in, lifting up through the head. Exhale out through the mouth. And go ahead and blink those eyes open. So again, our chair practice is very much the same as if you were seated on your mat. So today, if you prefer to be seated on your mat, you can do this entire practice with us, just modifying and making the little changes that you need to really feel strong and focused in your yoga practice. So from a seated position, I like to start out with a cat and cow posture. It really helps wake up and invigorate the spine and add some movement to where we hold a lot of stress. When you're seated, you just want to place your hands onto your thighs, take a deep breath in, and as you exhale, draw the navel to the spine, create a C or U shape with your spine, rolling your shoulders forward and your chest towards your legs. This is cat posture. As you inhale, we're gonna reverse. Inhale, press your chest forward, roll your shoulders back, and find that reverse curve through your spinal column. Exhale, cat. Inhale, cow. Exhale, cat. Inhale, cow. Let your breath guide your body through these movements. And take as much time as you need. You can adjust your hands to cup your knees. If you find that one of the movements feels better than the other, if you'll open that chest up, stay there a little longer. Just a few more. And then bring it back to center. Bring those feet a little bit closer. Again, they're about hips distance apart. We want to make sure that our feet are our stability here and that we feel them really pressing down. And we're going to just open up the side of the body. So I'm going to drop my right forearm onto my thigh and I'm going to take a look over my left shoulder. Then I'm going to start to reach my left hand up and breathe deeply. So my right forearm is really stabilizing my body here. My feet are pressing into the floor. And I'm pressing my left hip into the chair. Pressing my left palm up to the sky. Really a nice stretch as we breathe deeply. And you can look up, or you can look down, or you can look forward, wherever it feels best for your head and neck. So again, you shouldn't be holding your breath. You shouldn't feel any stress. If you like this posture and you want to take it a little further, you can let that left arm arc over the body just a little bit. Breathing in and out. Inhale and exhale. One more breath in and exhale. Just draw that elbow down slowly. Let's switch to the other side. So left forearm presses into the thigh. So again, we have our feet pressing down. We have our left forearm, not our elbow, pressing into that left thigh. We're gonna look over to the right and start to reach that right hand up towards the sky. Now notice, you might have a different range of motion on one side than the other. So just go with it. Nice deep breath in. Nice deep breath out. Decide where you wanna look and what feels good for your head and neck. Deep breath in and out. One more deep breath in. And out, just leaning a little bit here, arcing over the body, and bring it back. So feeling good, feeling strong, let's just reach those arms out, open the chest. Inhale, reach those hands high, and palms together as we exhale and bring them to heart center. Let's take a seated twist. Bring the right hand onto your left thigh, and the left hand onto the side of the chair. Inhale, sit up tall, and as you twist, exhale, chin to the left shoulder. Go ahead and look over that left shoulder, sitting up tall as we inhale. Exhale, open your heart. Inhale, growing taller. Exhale, twisting deeper. Nice deep breath in, and exhale. Inhale, back to center. Release the hands, take it to the other side. So left hand onto your right thigh, right hand to the outside of the chair. Inhale, sit up tall. Exhale, twist, looking over that right shoulder. Inhale, growing taller. Exhale, twisting deeper. Inhale, growing taller. Exhale, really feeling that heart space open up. One more deep breath in. And exhale. Take a deep breath in and exhale, bringing the head back to front and center. So just shaking it out, noticing how you feel here. We're gonna do a couple of sun salutations. Typically, this isn't something you see, but it can absolutely be done in a chair. So again, just making sure that we feel firm and strong in our seated position. We're gonna inhale and reach our arms out and up. Exhale, we're gonna forward fold, bringing our belly onto our thighs. Inhale, lengthen through your spine. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, press your feet into the ground as you lift and rise to the sky. Palms together overhead, and we exhale, hands to heart center. Let's do a few more of this. Inhale, reaching high. Exhale, swan dive forward. Inhale, lengthen through your spine. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, feet pressed to the earth, hands rise to the sky, palms together. As we exhale, hands to heart center. One more time, inhale, reaching up. Exhale, folding forward. Inhale, lengthen through your spine. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, feet pressed to the earth. Hands rise high. And exhale, hands to heart center. A favorite pose of mine that you don't see done in chair often is eagle pose. Eagle pose is a great pose, just bringing everything together, squeezing nice and tight. So we're gonna start out by crossing our legs. I brought my left foot to the center here. I'm gonna cross over with my right. Now again, make sure both sits bones are pressing down into the ground. We don't wanna be falling off of our chair one way or the other. So now that I feel strong, I can keep my right leg out, or if I want to, I can try to wrap it around my left calf, whatever you feel most comfortable with. For my arms, I have a couple of variations too, but what I want to tell you before we move to the arms is that the magic of this is squeezing through your core, squeezing through those thighs, squeezing those legs together nice and tight. So from here, our arm variations, we have two options. One is to give yourself a big hug. There it is. And we feel those elbows come together. We can lift them up just a little bit and breathe deeply. Breathing in and out. Now, if you want to try a second variation with the arms, keep your elbows together and bring your palms and fingers to touch. So in this variation, we're breathing, sitting up tall, breathing in and out. Inhale. And exhale, one more breath in and out. So gently unwind your wings and unwind your legs. Let's take eagle to the other side. So right foot now is our foundation and we cross over with the left. Now, if that's not comfortable for your body or not safe for your knees or your hips, any variation here, if you want to take a wider stance, no problem. Always modify your practice so that it's safe and comfortable for you, and you can find the benefit. You might have to help some of your body parts get to where they need to go too, so don't be worried about that. So again, we're crossing our left leg over our right, and we already start to feel that tightening and squeeze, which is really healthy for our body. Squeeze those thighs together, draw your navel into your spine. Left foot can be out, or you can tuck it behind your calf muscle. So sitting up, now we have to reverse our hands. So if we went to hug ourselves right over left, now we hug ourselves left over right. That's usually the hardest part. So give yourself a nice big hug. Feel that nice warm love as you hang out in your eagle pose. If you want to take your hands together in the second variation of your arms, keep your elbows together, and bring your palms and fingers to touch. Now, you may find that this side is a little bit different, and just notice how they come together. Nice deep breaths. Really feeling that opening that's happening in my upper back. Can you feel that too? Just breathing deeply and feeling that space underneath the shoulder blades. Let's do one more breath in and out. And let's unravel our arms, flap our wings, and bring it down. Let's focus a little bit on the lower part of the body. So again, we want to make sure that one foot is on the ground, stabilizing us so that we have a nice strong balance. We're going to start with some knee lifts. So if you need to, hold the side of the chair, draw that right knee up towards you, right foot off the floor. Notice how this feels, keep your core engaged. Now, if you need extra support, bring your right hand underneath your thigh. You can bring both hands underneath. Stay tall, don't collapse. If this is comfortable, you can also bring your hands in front of your shin. So again, whatever is right for you. Let's start with rotating through our ankle just a little bit here. And go in the opposite direction. And up and down with your foot, waving hello and goodbye. And then give a wiggle through those toes. Remember, don't take yourself too seriously. Let's come back to center, just drawing that right knee into the chest. Nice deep breaths. Sitting up tall. Now we're gonna add a little challenge. Feel free to take the challenge if it's right for you today. We're gonna bring the hands underneath the thighs if that's not where they were. And we're going to try to push that right leg out nice and straight. Now, as I do this, I'm gonna activate my core. I'm gonna draw my navel in towards my spine. I'm gonna maintain my left foot pressing into the ground. And I'm gonna try to take my right arm out and my left arm out. So I'm breathing, I'm really working on that core strength. Breathing in and out. Inhale and exhale. One more breath, stay with me. And we did it. Bend through that knee and bring that right foot down. Well done if you gave yourself that challenge. Let's take it to the other side. So again, if you want to, start out holding the sides of the chair. Press your right foot into the ground and just lift that left knee off the ground. Notice how this feels and what's comfortable for you today. If this feels good, maybe start playing around with your hand placements. One or two. Maybe out front on your shin. And let's circle through this ankle here. And the opposite direction. And up and down, waving hello and goodbye. And wiggling those toes just a little bit. See if you can spread those toes all the way apart, yogi toes. Good job. So again, you can hang out here, sit up tall, pull that knee into your chest, roll your shoulders back, and breathe deep. Or if you want a little bit of a challenge like we took on the other side, we can bring our hands underneath our left thigh and straighten that left leg out. One thing I didn't point out last time, my toes are activated and pointing towards the ceiling. Keeping my core engaged, pressing my right foot to the ground, I'm gonna try to extend my arms and take three breaths. With me now, deep breath in. Exhale, one. Inhale. Exhale, two. Inhale. Exhale, three. Bring that left foot down and hands up to the sky. Good job, everybody. Palms together. And exhale. Hands to heart. Let's open up our stance just a little bit for a little bit of a different pace here. So a lot of times, we have our legs and knees angled open for a yoga squat. Since we're already seated, we're gonna take a little bit of a different approach. We're gonna take our hands and press them into our thighs, so be careful not to put too much pressure on your knees. Take a deep breath in. And exhale, gently press your palms and open those knees just a little bit. Keep your back straight. Keep your feet pressing to the ground. Nice deep breaths here. Inhale, exhale. Nice little gentle stretch through the inner thighs. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Now let's add some shoulders. We're gonna drop that right shoulder towards the floor and look over the left shoulder up at the sky. Inhale back to center. Exhale, left shoulder towards the floor, looking over the right shoulder towards the sky. Inhale, center. Exhale, right. Inhale, center. Exhale, left. One more time. Inhale, center. Exhale, right. Inhale, center. Exhale, left. Inhale, back to center. Taking a little bit of our goddess pose, we're gonna inhale, arms are gonna reach out and up. And as we exhale, we're gonna bend through our elbows and let our shoulders roll back. Relax the hands in front of the body. Inhale, reach high. And exhale, goddess pose. Relax the hands in front of the body. Inhale, reach high. And goddess pose. One more time. Relax the hands in front of the body. Inhale, reach high. And goddess pose. Let's stay here. Roll your shoulders back. If you'd like, come onto the balls of your feet. And let those knees reach out and open. A couple of deep breaths here. Inhale. Exhale, one. Try a hand mudra if you would like. Bring your pointer finger and thumb together. Inhale. Exhale, two. Inhale. Exhale, three. Well done. Release the hands, release the heels. Walk those knees back into center. A lot of times we don't get our warrior postures when we're in a seated position. I want to show you how to do one of our most common warrior postures in a chair. So again, this is one of the most important reasons why we don't want sides on our chair. So to be able to open up into warrior two. I'm gonna start with my right leg. I'm gonna swing my right leg out to the side and back up just a little bit. I want the entire back of my right leg to be supported by my chair. Then I'm going to extend my left leg back nice and long. I'm starting in a lunge position. And if you wanted to go into your warrior one position here, you could do that. Hands at your heart or hands to the sky. Nice deep breaths. Breathing in and out. In and out. Now for warrior two, we're gonna bring our right hand forward, left hand back. Notice I've just opened up and angled my hip and dropped my left heel to the floor. So arms are open, nice and long, shoulders relaxed. I'm looking at my middle right finger. Nice deep breaths. Inhale. Exhale, one. Inhale. Exhale, two. Inhale. Exhale, three. Let's go into a side angle. Drop that right forearm onto the right thigh and reach that left hand towards the sky. Nice deep breaths. Inhale. Exhale, one. Now if you want, you can angle that arm across. Inhale. Exhale, two. Inhale. Exhale, three. And inhale. Bring it back to center. Warrior two. Warrior one. Bring that left foot around and swing it forward. So pretty easy, a little awkward when you do it for the first time, but it's a great way to modify our warriors. Let's take it to the other side. So, the back of the left thigh. And extend that right leg nice and long. So again, I'm in a lunge position here. My right leg is extended nice and long behind me. And I'm gonna come into a warrior one modified position. Hands can be up high. Breathing, focus on your breath. Breathing in and out. One more. Warrior two, we drop our right heel, left hand reaching forward, right hand reaching back. Just make sure that you're comfortable and you feel sturdy here in your posture. Looking forward, looking at that middle finger on the left hand. Deep breath in and out as one. Inhale. Exhale, two. Let your shoulders relax. Inhale. Exhale, three. Inhale. Right hand forward, warrior one. Hands down. And then back to center. And you do want to do right side and left side. And so let's take it back because let's not forget our side angle. Put that left forearm down. And reach that right hand to the sky. Nice deep breaths. Again, if you want to, you can reach that right arm over. Nice deep breaths. And then bring it back to center. Always keeping ourselves balanced. And we come back and we focus. So bringing ourselves back up to the edge, I want to do pigeon. It's a half pigeon, and it's really beautiful to open up all the stagnant energy in your hips. So press your left foot into the ground and place your right ankle onto your left thigh. Go ahead and press that right knee down so that you actually feel like your body is making the shape of a chair. Sit up tall. And you might already feel that opening up in that right hip. If you want to intensify this just a little bit, you can start to lean forward and start to feel a deeper opening in that right hip. Nice deep breaths here. Inhale. Exhale, one. Inhale. Exhale, two. Inhale. Exhale, three. Let's come back up to seated. And we're going to take it to the other side. So right foot pressing down, left ankle onto that right thigh. And pressing that left knee down, opening up our lap. Again, this might feel excellent. You may not want to do anything else here. So nice deep breaths if you're really feeling that left hip open up. Those hip flexors. If you want to take it a little further, go ahead and lean forward slightly and feel that open up right into the glutes and the lower back. Deep breaths in and out. Inhale, exhale, inhale, and exhale. Awesome. Coming back up and getting ourselves situated. A couple of standing postures are excellent to do using a chair as a prop. So today, because I'm using a bench, I'm gonna modify just a little bit. But you can come to standing and use the back of your chair or the seat of your chair as your prop to do some of our standing balancing postures. So let's get up safely. And I'm gonna step to the side of my bench here and take a variation on tree pose. So typically, you have one leg as your standing leg. I'm gonna bring my opposite leg onto the bench or onto the seat of the chair. So I'm standing tall with my right foot as my base. My left knee is here, and I'm gently just gonna press my left foot into my right calf muscle. Keep your core engaged. Arms out, shoulders rolled back. This is a great variation on tree pose, giving you just a little extra balance and support. And again, any variation of tree pose here. If you wanna bring your palms together up overhead, be your tree. Breathing in, breathing out. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Hands to heart center and lower your branch and root. Awesome. The second standing pose that I want to show you using this chair as a prop is half moon. So for half moon, we're going to bring our left palm onto the seat of the chair. Or if you have a higher back chair, you can use the higher back of the chair. I want to make sure that my shoulder, elbow, wrist is in a nice straight line. I'm going to bring my right hand to my hip, and I'm going to reach my right leg towards the back of the room. This could be the extent of the half moon. If it feels comfortable for you, stay here. Or you can start to take any modification that feels good. So from here, I could reach my right hand up towards the sky, look up, and take three breaths. Inhale, exhale, one. Inhale, exhale, two. Inhale, exhale, three. Nice job. Let's bring it back down to the ground and come to standing. Taking it to the other side. And what we do on the right side, we want to do on the left. It may not always feel the same, so just be gentle and kind with yourself. Tree pose on your left side. Left foot is your standing foot. Bring that right knee onto the base of the chair, and your right foot over to your left calf muscle. Be careful not to press that right foot into your knee. That's where we can get into injuries, and we always want to keep yoga benefiting our body instead of hurting. So again, we stand here, arms down, shoulders rolled back. Left foot pressing into the ground. Standing tall and sturdy like a tree. Again, any modification you want with your hands, your arms, wherever they feel good. Breathing deep. Breathing in and out. Inhale and exhale. And relax. Nice job. Half moon on this side. We're gonna bring our right hand down. Shoulder, elbow, wrist in a nice straight line. Our right foot is our standing foot. Left hand to the hip. We're gonna reach that left leg back. And again, this might be your comfort. You may not need to take this any further. If you would like to, you may. You can reach that left hand towards the sky. You can take your gaze to follow. Nice deep breaths. Inhale, exhale one. Inhale, exhale two. Inhale, exhale three. Nice job. Go ahead and look down, left hand down, left foot down, and we come up to standing. Let's take our seat and finish up just with a little bit of a seated meditation. Find a comfortable position the way we started. Place your hands wherever they feel comfortable. Close your eyes, take a deep breath in, and a deep breath out. Just try to relax the physical parts of your body. Relax your muscles. Relax the mind. Focus on the breath. Notice the breath as it comes in and out of the body. Notice your heart and how you're feeling. And try to keep a full balance of the body, mind, and spirit. Bringing your hands to your heart, making a commitment to yourself and to others in your practice of yoga. Namaste.